happy Tuesday, B-Fam, and happy World Day of Migrants and Refugees. I'm sure many of us can relate na, you know, the life of migrants. Most of us, B-Fam, ay pumunta abroad in search of a better life. And sometimes it works out just fine, but other times, some may have to make a U-turn that completely shifts the course of their lives. And to those who are lucky, this change has become their ticket to success. So for today, let's explore inspiring stories of our GP Noys and their life's U-turns. Kasama niyo pa rin ako dito, syempre, your boy next boy, VJ Miranda, here on The Place to Be. Be happy, be you, be RGY. B-Fam, simulan natin with the biggest and most talked about happenings worldwide. Only here on today's Big Happenings. For our first story, let's give spotlight to a Pinay who never gave up even after almost 20 years of postponing. Helwina Sadora, a past UP, British Council, Korean Embassy, and ABS-CBN employee, just completed her degree 18 years after her first enrollment at UP Diliman. She was so sure that she would finish her degree when she enrolled back in 2004 that she even took a graduation photo na. Ganun na siya ka-ready. Pero para supportan ang kanyang pamilya, kailangan niyang i-postpone ang pag-aaral sa university para magtrabaho. And her 18-year gap even included being a coach for Kapamilya stars, ang sikat na sikat, of course, Sam Milby and Edward Barber. Despite being the oldest person in her class, she did not allow that to stop her. Sabi nga niya, kung gusto mo talaga siyang tapusin, ipaglaban mo siya. Dahil mahalaga sa iyo yung degree, alam mong magagamit mo siya. Gusto kong magturo, so importante sa akin yung degree if I really want to practice teaching. That's her values, and kitang-kita naman, again, after so many years, binalikan niya pa rin yung gusto niyang balikan. And this year nga, she finally received her diploma and shared her joy in a Facebook post that also went viral. And now that she has completed her undergraduate degree, she is aiming to pursue graduate studies naman. Uy, tuloy-tuloy yung ano, ang pag-aaral, no? Learning never stops, and we are inspired on how you keep coming back, Helwina. Grabe, super nakaka-inspire. And grabe, no, with her story, parang it really gives us an idea na pwede nga ba mag-U-turn talaga and balikan yung something na importante sa atin 18 years after. Pinakita niya na for her, kayang-kaya niyang gawin. And personally for me, kunwari, mangyari sa akin yun na after 18 years, 18 years, or basta sobrang tagal na, probably also, kasi dati yung pangarap ko is maging architect. And it's super crazy kasi now na inaayos ko yung place ko, for example, parang bumabalik yung love ko with designing houses or designing home na dati naalala ko, gumagawa lang ako ng mga floor plan sa bahay, ganyan. So, it's those things na akala mo, di mo nababalikan. And somehow, babalik din talaga sa'yo sa buhay mo and may enjoy mo pa rin siyang gawin as well. So, B-Fam, don't be afraid to make some U-turns as well. Pero ito, next on TBH is a PBB alumnus, Ylona Garcia, who returned to her Filipino roots when she sang Lupang, Hinirang for the Dodgers Filipino Heritage Night in Los Angeles. Actually, last year nga, Ylona moved to the US to pursue a music career in Hollywood. Hindi pa rin naman nakalimot sa Pinoy roots niya si Ylona with her performance on this event last August 2. Despite being nervous, sabi niya sa kanyang IG post pa nga na, ito ang kanta na nagre-representa sa aking sarili at sa aking bansa. Very proud siya as a Pinoy, and she also said that she wanted to make sure that her tone and timing was perfect kasi gusto niya tayong maging masaya at ma-impress. Sabi pa nga niya, sana ay proud kayo, Pilipinas. Nako, Ylona, sobrang proud kami sa'yo, and patuloy mo lang i-represent ang Pilipinas with your amazing voice and music. We are always here just cheering for you here sa Philippines as well. And of course, grabe si Ylona, no? Kasi she came from Australia, moved to the Philippines, nag-PBB, nag-showbiz, and then now pursuing her career naman sa US. Talagang all those things na nangyayari, hindi siya talaga nawala sa core niya of being a Filipino. And I feel like we can learn something from her as well. No? For example, ako mag-move sa Pinas, siguro as someone who loves food talaga, isa yun sa mga hindi pwedeng mawala sa, ano, sa routine ko, kumakain ng mga Filipino food. And just really looking for example, mga groups out there that can really maintain our Filipino communities. And nung nag-Canada nga ako, for example, parang Thanksgiving day yon sa Canada. And then, nakakatawa kasi a Filipino friend of mine invited me over para mag-celebrate ng Thanksgiving. Although di nila ako kamag-anak, although kakakilala ko lang sa friend ko na yon, that's how hospitable us Filipinos are. Talagang magtutulungan tayo to celebrate and really maintain that sense of community, whether here in the Philippines and lalong-lalo na sa abroad, di ba? And ito, last na natin sa TBH is another familiar face, Marvin Agustin, who made a U-turn from the hospitality, food, and beverage industry back naman to showbiz. Bukod nga sa pagiging sikat na aktor for TV and film, kilala na nga rin ngayon si Marvin sa kanyang restaurants and food businesses such as yung Secret Kitchen and his very, very famous, whether TikTok, Instagram, Facebook na, Conchinillo. And now, after 3 years, Marvin says he wants to go back to showbiz once again. And grabe, talking about U-turn, no, talagang one good idea nga ng U-turn yung ginagawa ngayon ni Sir Marvin Agustin. Pero this time, he has a specific goal naman to combine showbiz with his food industry experience. Sabi niya sa isang interview, gusto kong gumawa ng mga projects na mag-highlight lalo sa mga food industry yung kwento ng hirap na pinagdadaanan naming lahat. So, of course, we're so excited to see something like this from Marvin Agustin. So, hopefully, may ganong movie na darating pa with the help from him as well. And looking back siguro, ang ganda na story nito kay Sir Marvin kasi kilalang kilala siya for showbiz nga and then nag-transfer to a different passion and now going back. Siguro, if that were to happen to me, na nakapag mag-U-turn ba? Kasi as I keep on mentioning, no, I do software development. So, programming talagang computer lang talaga, which is mostly math and logic. Siguro I wouldn't say I will take a full U-turn going back to actually coding. Pero I feel like yung mga nakukuha ko sa kanilang skills na kunwari problem solving, innovation, and development, these are something that I can still really look forward to doing. Kasi when it comes to programming, you're solving a problem to make things more efficient. And if it were for me to really try it again, ganun lang, more on the problem solving, look for a problem na pwedeng masolusyonan, whether it's a business, whether it's a show, whether it's a vlog, for example, anything that can solve a problem, yan ang aking aatupagin. So, grabe, simula pa lang yan ang ating mga inspirational na mga U-turn stories. Pero when we return, our B-fam from Canada will share how a U-turn from the past created a new path in her life. Pag-uusapan natin yan sa pagbabalik ng BRGY.
The sun, oh, you.